Penguin Random House Audio presents
How May We Hate You?
Notes from the Concierge Desk.
These are the authors, Anna Drezen
and Todd Dakotah Briscoe.
Oh, God, you have to help me. I've lost my daughter in Macy's.
Oh, no, let me get a description. How old is she?
36.
Introduction. Who are we to write this book? Are we two ungrateful millennials angry at having to actually work? Are we two bitter curmudgeons who love making people angry?
Nah, we're just two comedians who found ourselves working in the hospitality industry as concierges, and we couldn't believe some of the outrageous things that guests would say to us. We wanted to share them with the world. We really don't like to hurt people's feelings, which is why everyone in this book is anonymous.
Hi, we're Todd.
And Anna.
We met at NYU, where we studied pretending.
AKA theater.
Upon graduating and realizing that the world doesn't care about dreams, we found ourselves needing a day job, or what most people just call a job, so that we could buy beers at our friends' weird theater shows in Chelsea basements.
We were too clumsy to carry things, so waiting tables was out. We didn't want the pressure of keeping children alive, so babysitting was out. And we weren't into having strangers touch our feet, so escorting was out. We just wanted day jobs that would give us time in front of a computer so we could read Gawker and stalk our exes.
Hotels it was. Make a couple of reservations, give a few directions, suggest a couple Broadway shows. Sounds easy enough, right?
Wrong. Unfortunately, the vast majority of the people we dealt with were difficult. Here are some typical daily interactions. I need a salon appointment, wash and blow, Saturday at 12.
All right, you are confirmed for a wash and blow at Bon Bon Salon for Saturday at noon.
Ugh.
Is that all right?
Well, I'm just very dubious about the quality of a salon that actually has space at 12 on a Saturday. Is there another one you recommend?
So you want me to recommend a salon that won't have space at the time you're requesting?
Yes. Let's try that.
Or... What floor is my floor on?
Which floor are you on?
5.
The 5th floor.
Great, thanks. Instead of using our 12-hour shifts to get some writing done, we found ourselves growing mentally exhausted from hours of helping guests who are variously angry, constipated, scared, or cheating on their wives.
We started the blog How May We Hate You as a coping mechanism. We'd post our ridiculous or hilarious or rage-inducing guest interactions on Facebook just to blow off steam.
Apparently, all of our friends enjoy seeing us in pain because the flood of likes and comments was more than anything we expected. The consensus from friends, family, and girls we met at a party once was that they couldn't wait to hear more of our awkward interactions with guests.
As the blog took off, thousands of other hospitality employees flooded us with emails and comments, thanking us for finally giving the name tag wearer a point of view and a place to turn for comfort when guests were driving them up the walls.
Of course, the inevitable call came from our boss.
Hey, saw the blog.
Okay.
Thought it was funny.
And?
Don't mention anyone's name or the hotel's name.
Okay.
Also, can you pick up a shift Saturday morning?
No. Then another.
Hey, did you talk to Anna?
No.
Saw the blog.
Okay.
I thought it was funny.
And?
Don't mention anyone's name or the hotel's name.
Okay.
Also, any chance you can work Saturday morning? No.
Remember a few years ago when a JetBlue flight attendant quit his job by telling a plane full of assholes to fuck off, grabbed a handful of mini liquor bottles, and slid down the escape slide into the hearts of America?
Remember how much you wished your office window had an inflatable slide?
You weren't alone. Everybody has something work-related to gripe about, and we're here to give voice to those complaints for anyone in the service industry. Our experiences are specific to hotels, but we hope you can relate to them whether you work in phone customer service, in a restaurant, doing tech support, or hell, even if your job is awesome. Even if you're a professional athlete or singer or politician or the CEO of a Fortune 500 company, odds are good that at some point, you were wearing a name tag, too.
Everyone has had to swallow his or her pride and serve a jerk.
It's easy to become resentful and take it out on the guests, but that's not who we are. Yes, we're snarky little bitches in the face of absurdity, absolutely. But we have empathy, too.
And we're by no means perfect at our job either. I once saw a high-end concierge who said in an interview, "I can do anything you need done. The impossible? Give me an hour. A miracle? I may need a day or two."
She is our public enemy number one. Her name is usually something like Pam, and we hate her.
Go to hell, Pam.
Chapter 1. The Concierge.
The what?
We feel that 90% of our frustrations would be resolved if people actually knew what a concierge can and can't do. We're recommending that this section of the book be handed to every guest upon check-in so that we don't get a call from room 1602 asking where their $17 plate of fries is. Hint, not our desk.
First of all, what the hell is a concierge?
Sure, let me Google that for you. Wikipedia tells me that the word concierge comes from the French compte de cierge, which translates literally to keeper of the candles. This was an occupation held by medieval peasants and involved lighting the ostentatious amount of candles of the nobility. In the 18th and 19th centuries, concierges presided over residences in Paris. They would hold the keys, hold mail, monitor the building, and basically do the same things that modern-day doormen do. Now, our responsibilities are a little different. We made a little list for you that should help explain what we can and can't do for you as concierges.
Yes, sir, we can absolutely.
Help you get tickets to a Broadway show.
Tell you about the neighborhood around the hotel.
Make dinner reservations and recommendations.
Help you book transportation.
Make an itinerary for a day or a few days, based on your interests.
Help you guess which place you remember, have heard of, or saw on TV.
Plan some special stuff for your honeymoon or anniversary.
Tell you where the nearest pharmacy is for your unmentioned but strongly implied contraceptive needs.
And tell you that you look very nice in your tuxedo and or ball gown.
We don't usually do this, but I can certainly
help you find a broker to resell your Broadway tickets that you can no longer use.
Try to arrange a very last-minute taxi, train, or shuttle to the airport.
Make a last-minute rooftop bachelorette tapas brunch party reservation for 15 people.
Help you find the wallet you left in a cab.
Hide your Tiffany engagement ring brochure in our desk so your girlfriend won't find out about your proposal plans. That one's fun.
Draw an entire map of locations from Sex and the City.
Make a giant heart of red rose petals on your hotel bed for your very special honeymoon/anniversary sexathon.
Point you in the exact immediate direction of condoms.
Help you tie your bow tie for your tuxedo and or zip up your ball gown.
I apologize, but unfortunately we cannot.
Get you quote-unquote cheap tickets for Hamilton.
Get you a free limo, taxi, or shuttle.
Get you and your 9 cheap-ass friends into Balthazar for an 8 p.m. res at 7:30 on a Friday.
Help you visit a location that is not in New York.
Procure illegal drugs and or a hooker.
Get you a room with a view of a particular building that is blocked by a mile of other, taller buildings.
Ask the office of the city clerk to allow you to use your concealed weapons permit as photo ID for your shotgun wedding, especially because it doesn't have your photo on it, and yes, this occurred.
Personally apply the condoms. And fortunately, that has not actually occurred.
Tailor your tuxedo and or ball gown on the spot as you're wearing it while someone is hailing you a taxi.
Great, so you check me in, hold my bags, arrange housekeeping, take my room service order, and light my candles?
No, sir, is that really what you think we do?
I need to see your manager.
Have you seen a candle in this hotel at all? Have you seen a single candle?
Huh?
Certainly, I can get my manager for you. He is schmoozing with a guest who spends $30,000 a year here, so he'll be right with you after their golf game.
Never mind, can I check out here now?
You check out at the same place you checked in, the front desk. They're your guides for everything in the hotel. I'm your guide for everything outside the hotel.
You don't care that my room wasn't cleaned properly?
Personally, no, not really.
That is so unprofessional of you. I'm upset with my room being dirty, so you should do something about it.
Would you go to the bank to complain about the post office?
You work for the same hotel. You're passing the buck because you're lazy.
No, it's not about lazy. It's about unions. Every department has its own designated responsibilities, and the workers within those departments are usually protected by their own unions. I'm supposed to stick to my job, and they're supposed to stick to theirs.
You don't seem like your one life goal is to serve me.
My one life goal is to afford therapy.
Didn't you say something about lighting candles earlier? I'd very much like to know who is lighting my candles.
Open flames aren't permitted in the hotel, sir.
Did you know?
Did you know concierges have been characterized in many popular movies, including Life with Mikey, Home Alone 2, Lost in New York, and Can You Hand Me a Map and Mark Directions to the Empire State Building, you filthy slut number 7?
You know, I almost booked that.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Next time.
Yeah. Did you know that we absolutely strongly recommend this Italian restaurant that's 10 blocks from here because they homemake all their pastas, the service is impeccable, it feels like you're in Rome, and they're giving me $5 per person I send over there?
Where's a good place for a massage?
Well, there's a great spa on 33rd.
This place is, good?
Yes, sir.
But, like, good?
Yes, sir.
But not for women.
It's good for men and women, sir.
Can someone come to my room?
Oh, sure, we can arrange an in-room massage.
But, like, for men?
Yeah, we can arrange an in-room massage.
But for, like, you know, men?
I think I know. Yeah, we can request a male or female masseuse for you.
Oh, female, female.
Okay, you know what? It sounds like you're not really decided yet. I can give you their number directly.
You can't arrange it for me?
Let me just get this straight. You're looking for a massage for men?
Yeah.
No, I can't arrange it. That's illegal. Helpful tips. How to use your room phone.
Quite often, the phone systems in the rooms can be confusing. We understand that. Too many buttons make the brain hurt. Here's a helpful guide for letting you know which department to call at the appropriate time. See that button that says housekeeping? Push that for housekeeping.
See the button that says bellman? Pressing this will get you a bellman.
See the button that says concierge? Why, that will get you the concierge.
See the button that says front desk? This will ring the phone at the front desk.
See that button that says room service? That will get you the front desk. No, wait, it'll get you room service.
See the button that says operator? This button is the operator's button. That's why they wrote his name on it.
Or, you know, you can also just press random buttons and yell at people.
Oh, and by the way, the part with the little handle on it? That's the part you talk into. And now, a quiz. We see a concierge behind a desk. She is smiling. Why is she smiling?
A. She received a fantastic TripAdvisor review.
B. She knows the appropriate greeting for a guest is eye contact and a smile.
C. A coworker just made a humorous remark about the weather.
Or D. She just drank a Coors Light in the handicap bathroom.
Answer? D. She's drunk.
This is something I did at least 3 times.
Honestly? Honestly, I am so incredibly sorry you didn't like the Greek restaurant I recommended last night. This is the first I've heard that the ceiling is literally caving into the plates of food and that the maitre d' is picking his scabs. Well, maybe I knew all that, but I'm doing the math in my head, and if you're a party of 8 and I'm getting 15 per person I send, then no, I'm not really sorry because last night I went drunk shopping and spent my rent money on a vintage leather jacket that doesn't really fit, but maybe will one day. It's an aspirational jacket.
Can you give me a list of modeling agencies? I want to take my daughter while we're in town.
Helpful tips. Manage your expectations.
When you peruse the websites of some of the finest hotels across the world, the marketing copy describes the concierge as something akin to a genie. Make your wildest dreams come true. They live to serve you. Your wish is their command. The concierge lives in a bottle we keep under a desk and wears lace veils. Rub it.
This might be true at those properties where the concierge is making nearly 6 figures, but those hotels aren't the kind offering a continental breakfast in the lobby with hordes of screaming children running around throwing bacon at each other. Those hotels have more to offer than free HBO. Those hotels aren't, well, chains that you'd find in any city.
If you got a great deal via a discount website for a room that seems like it hasn't been remodeled in 15 years, don't expect your concierge to be Ritz-Carlton material. We're not going to be able to get you into Saturday Night Live last minute. I mean, we could, but we're not going to burn our connection on Dave and Mary from Iowa just because they're paying to stay in room 1433.
The term concierge is shifting.
What was once the keeper of the keys is now more the Googler.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.